Did you know our church has a visitation ministry? If you or your family are hospitalized, ill, or just need someone to stop by, call the church office and let us know. A member of our visitation team will be given your information and will stop by soon.
New Beginnings class starts this week.
The class meets every Sunday evening at 6 p.m. on the fourth floor downtown at the GP.
You'll study the book of Ephesians, and this class is a requirement for becoming a GP member.
See Deb Benninger for more information.
Quick reminders, Amped Teens meets tonight at 6.
Youth band practice today after church.
Wednesday's Bible study at 7.
That's it for GP 120.
Have a great week!
Good morning. Good to see everybody. Do you guys like the announcements that way? Isn't that good? I think you get it better than hearing it from the elders and the other people. It's that's so much better. It's a lot more fun. That's good. That is a good thing. Before we pray, I just want to share something with you. Maybe you deal with these things, but it's definitely something that I deal with, and I really want to just speak a little bit about this morning. And I don't think it's someone, it doesn't have to be someone that's just new to the walk with the Lord. It can even be happening with those that have been walking for the Lord a long time. I think sometimes when things are in our life that feel uncomfortable, that we don't like, we tend to maybe ignore them. Just maybe pretend that they don't really exist. But we are in a spiritual battle. And there's good and there's evil in our midst all the time. I don't want to think about the bad, but it's real and it's going on. There's not a gray area that's in our life. I think sometimes we, knowingly or unknowingly, we tend to go there or think that's where we are, especially when we leave here today, that we tend to think that those things don't really matter, but they do. And the thing that I'm dealing with, there's many things that I deal with. But the one thing, and I spoke to Pastor about it, it's silly, was that when I would watch, and I'm sure this is going to strike a chord with someone else in here, but when I would watch a Ohio State football game there and they were doing poorly, I would get so angry that I couldn't watch the game. Now, that's silly. That is silly. I'm a fan, but not to the point where anger has to take me over to the point where I feel it's awful, and that's not right. So what I used to do was I'd get up and just, this is funny, but my wife would say, let me get my list out, because she knew that if that was going on, she could give me that list and I would go get busy doing something. So it was an opportunity to go do things around the house that maybe I need to do, but that wasn't the right way I needed to deal with it. Okay, walking away isn't a bad thing, but there's another thing that I have to recognize. So the Holy Spirit was convicting me of this. This isn't right. This is leading, and as I started to study about these things that are going on in your life and in my life, and I'm speaking to myself, and if it speaks to you, then it does, but then it's me confessing this morning. But as I looked into these things, I found out that through the Word, it's telling us that these things are not good, and they're leading to other things in my life. They're going to manifest into other things that are not good, and I don't know what those are. But I know that in James 3:16 it said, where jealousy, bitter envy, self-seeking, strife, anger. It says there's confusion, disorder, commotion, instability, and every evil work is in that. I'm not serving Satan willingly, but unknowingly, I am. I don't want to do that. God wants to bless me. He wants to bless you. He's doing everything he can to bless, heal, prosper us. Satan is out to kill, steal, and destroy. Who are we serving? I'm saying that we do this sometimes without even thinking. It becomes part of just what we fall into. Our words are powerful. As we enter into those things, that affects me. That will affect my infect, not affect. It affects me, but it infects my family, me, my business, your workplace, as a leader in the church, it can affect you. I don't want to do that. So that's something I have to deal with. And the Lord is dealing with me on those things. He's opening my eyes. But from that, I have to be aware that that battle is real. The flesh, the world, the devil, those are real things. It's going on. It's not fun to talk about, but it's real. There's a spiritual battle taking place in my life and in yours. We have to recognize it. What he was showing with me this morning is it has to begin with me. We've been talking about this through the elders and the pastor. We need to go out. We need to witness to people. But if I don't protect my witness, if I'm not allowing that change that God wants in my life, I can't witness a soul. The change, I can see all kinds of things in our community, in our world that needs change. But it has to begin with us. It has to begin with me. If it can't happen in me, I can't. It won't happen in other people. I don't believe it's people that don't know the Lord. I'm not saying people that know the Lord that may be able to deal with these things better. But I'm saying these things are real and they're happening in my life. I hope they're not in yours. But I know that Satan is still at work. He has no power. He has no power. We are drawn away by our own lusts. It's us. He's real, but we make those choices. The Holy Spirit lives in each and every one of you. Those first three fruits of the Spirit that he gives us, that love, peace, and joy, that is teaching us how to deal with the Father. If we can't have love and peace and joy towards the Father, if we're not being obedient and listening to him, that's where it begins. Love is the greatest of all those fruits. It begins there. That can only happen. I can choose that, but that's only going to happen when the Holy Spirit, he'll do that. But I have to let him do it. God is committed to every one of us. He loves us. He is a great Father. We prayed that this morning. Candy spoke that. He is a loving Father. He's a lot of things. I don't have time to go over all the things that he is. He's amazing. When you look at in the Word and you see how many times we fell and he's lifted us up again, and the oppression and deliverance is just constant, but he's right there sending people to help him keep going. So I hope this is an encouragement today. I want you to be able to see these things and start to recognize them. If it's in your life, different things that aren't right, start to recognize these things. Look in the Word. It's not righteousness in Steve's eyes, it's righteousness in the Father's eyes. Too much in our world today is, what do I think is right? It doesn't matter what I think is right. It's what does God think is right. I'm only going to discover that when I know him through the Word, through the Holy Spirit. You can see in the Word, obedience brings blessings in life. Disobedience brings curses and death. It's all through the Word. I want the best for me, but I want the best for you. It's available. It takes commitment. It takes a little effort along with that commitment, but it's available. God's doing everything he can to bless us, but Satan is also working to defeat us and kill and destroy us. So this is going on, it's real. So my message to you this morning is just be alert, be wise, slower to speak, slower to anger. Those things that help us, we can do that. We can overcome those things. Jesus overcame. Look, he overcame by the Word. He defeated all those things that Satan brought against him. I'm not telling you it's going to be easy. I'm just telling you it is possible. And we're in this sanctification process throughout our life. And the Word says even beyond life, we're still being. So it's a process that's going to last a lifetime. And that's okay. But let's keep moving forward. Let's recognize those things in our life that don't align with Him. We want to change our community. I believe that. There's people in here that want to see different. We see things going on that hurt us. It's painful to see the drugs, all the things. Marriages, divorce, all those things that we see. There's just all kinds of things. But it has to begin with us. That's what the Lord is impressing on me. So let's go to prayer. Lord, we thank You for this day. And I'm asking right now, Your Holy Spirit, Lord, to fill each and every one of us, Lord. To illuminate those dark places that are in our life, Lord, that don't align with You. Lord, and that we become obedient. When You speak, that we respond. Lord, we're good about realizing truth, but we're not good about responding and doing something about it. We can receive a truth and it excites us, Lord, but yet it just remains there. It's only good when we apply it. So, Lord, let us receive that truth, and then let us respond and let us apply it, Lord. And let's give You the glory, because we say, look, this is how the Lord spoke to me, and it changed. It changed everything. I thank You for the worship leaders this morning, Lord. I pray that You're going to anoint this music, these songs, everything, Lord. Everything that's going to be played and sung here this morning. Let us worship You this morning in spirit and truth, and let us be free. Thank You for our pastor. Thank You for the message, Lord. Anoint our ears and let us receive it in our heart this morning, Lord. Let us take something away today that prophesies. Lord, let us be here seeking something, Lord, expecting something this morning, Lord. We're going to get something special from this service and this day. We expect it and we believe it. I just thank You for all that You're doing in this church and in this leadership, all the people, Lord. We just thank You and we give You praise today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. If everybody could stand up with me, please. It's a good word that Steve gave us. And I'd like for us to get into an attitude of worship. God is worthy, and our Father is so loving, and He loves everyone in this room so much. The love of God is something that will never be measured until we get to heaven. You have never had unconditional love in the earth. Maybe somebody came close in your life, but you've never really had it. That agape love of God. So let's come and worship Him. Because He loved us first. We love Him. Have a respect and a reverential fear, which is respect for God. So I'd like to ask more of you to come on up here with us. If you would. Sometimes it's a little easier to enter in when you're up here. Tracy Bim's here. She just gave birth to some things. She had a hysterectomy. And it was robotic surgery. And it was, you know, it's pretty serious surgery. And she had that on Thursday. And she wants to be in church today. And Jim Bauman had a heart cath on, a stent put in on Wednesday, and Jim's here because he wants to be here. And they are an inspiration to me today because we pretty much do what we want to do, don't we? And we've got to understand that if we're going to serve Christ, which is the head, we also have to serve the body, which is the church. You can't decapitate the head from the body. Serve one and not the other. And we serve the church by being here, by being together, by encouraging one another, by worshiping freely so that the person next to us feels comfortable to worship freely as well. Amen? All right, let's sing.
You've been walking the same old road for
miles and miles. If you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lies, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, there's a better life, such a better life. We know it.
I think we should have all the children up here. Come on up, all you children. Get up here close. Hey, you kids know that the country we live in was founded by people that believed on the Lord. And it was founded on the Christian principles. And our founding fathers were Christians. And they loved the Lord. And they put this country together so that we could have a place where we could worship and praise the Creator of the heaven and universe. Do you guys know the Pledge of Allegiance? Do you? You want to say it with me? There's a flag over there. Let's say the Pledge of Allegiance together, because there's a phrase in there that talks about God. You ready? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, and indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Aren't you glad we live in the United States? This is a great place. Father, I thank you for every one of these boys and girls, and I bless them. And I want them to know the truth. I don't want them to be deceived by secularism and the things that Satan is trying to interject into our beliefs. But I want them to be able to stand strong knowing the truth. And we live in a Christian nation. God has had his hand on America because we've been so generous with other countries that don't have anything. And Lord, I'm going to pray that the truth always comes through. And though they'll hear other things, let them know, God, you are the Creator. Everything is here, God, because you put it here. So I'm going to bless these children, and I bless their parents for bringing them. And it's a great morning, and I pray that they'll just have a wonderful, wonderful outpouring of the Spirit of the Lord on them, that their teachers are anointed and things are said, Lord, that'll make a big difference in their life. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Well, good morning.
Candy asked me to share about this song and how this song came about. It's called Thy Will Be Done. And the writer of the song had a miscarriage, and it was supposed to be her second child, and she really struggled with it. And she said this was literally the letter she wrote to God. And I think what makes a song great is that it's relatable. And we've all had times where we question God and we ask why and we don't understand. But at the end of it, it comes down to your will. Your ways are higher than our ways. Your thoughts are higher than our thoughts. So I just want to challenge you this morning to remember that your greatest pain, from your greatest pain will come your greatest purpose. So if you're struggling and you're just questioning God, or maybe you're in a season where you're not, but you can look back and see a time where you were and see that all things work together for good. They always do. That's a promise. And if you can't see it now, you'll be able to see it one day. So just trust. Trust in the one who holds your future.
Somehow I ended up Child of God, you unravel me with your melody, you surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies till all. And I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. And I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Chosen me, your love has called my name. I've been born again to your family. Your blood flows through my veins, and I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God, and I'm no longer. I'm no longer a slave to fear.
You know, there was a teenager that posted her suicide video on social media. And as I sing that song, I am a child of God. I am full of favor. I know that the word of God that stood true 2,000 years ago stands true today. And what I am a Christian. And I say I believe in Christ. That person, that was a spirit of fear. That was the devil. That was the inner workings of Satan inside her. But I can tell any teenager that is out there, I've been there. I know what you're going through. You don't have to go through that, because the same power that resurrected Jesus from the grave, he's about to resurrect you into something. He's about to resurrect you into a brand new life.
Father, I bless you. These are true words. Fear is not of God. Lord, we are your children, and we need to know who we are. We have power and authority through the Spirit working in us. Not in and of ourselves, but the Spirit working in us. And I thank you for everybody that's here. I thank you for every church in this community that's meeting today. I thank you, Lord Jesus, that we can bring our needs to you. You're always faithful. You take care of us. We're your children. We trust you. We bless you. And this day is a special day for everybody that's in this place. For every day that we wake up and we walk in this existence, in this human condition, Lord Jesus, there are things that are happening. You're working in our lives. Sometimes we fail to see it. Sometimes we don't feel it. But you're working in our lives. So, Lord, let that happen today. For everybody that's here, let your Spirit be at work in their lives. Help us, Lord, to be able to get ourselves out of the way, so that your Spirit, your anointing, comes on us in Jesus' name. Amen. Give somebody a hug. It's love that breaks everything.
Can I get you to pray for my parents?
Yes. Absolutely. I would love to.
As John knows, I really don't get up here in front of everybody very often, but I'd like to thank everybody for their prayers. Even people that didn't even know me was praying, and it guided the surgeon's hand, and he went in, and I had a 90% blockage, and it was a main artery, and with all your prayers and everything, it guided the surgeon's hand, and he was able to take care of it. So I should be good as new. And I want to thank John for coming up and seeing me. It was a blessing. It really uplifted my day. And I want to thank you all.
Love you, Jim. Jim's first question to the surgeon after they put his stent in was, he said, "Can I go to church Sunday morning and help set up chairs?" Is that amazing? That's a servant.
If the ushers will go ahead and get in place, we're going to do prayer requests, and then we're going to do the offering. So if we have prayer requests, yep. That last song, thoughts on that is just today, tomorrow when we get up, all next week, all next month, all next year, for the rest of her life, we are a child of God. We cannot ever forget that. And it's just amazing. That was one thing that Pastor Mark, Tuesday night in our ministry class, that he spent some time right there in the realization. He said we can never forget that. That's important. And I just thought that was just fitting for this morning, but we can never forget that. That's who we are. And if you're not really clear on that, you need to do some searching and praying. Let that be clear. That needs to be very clear. Because love, God loves you unbelievably. I couldn't even begin to describe it. So let's go ahead and let's do these prayer requests. Father, I know that you are an amazing Father, and that when your children are ill and they're sick and they're going through things, Lord, I'm sure that it pains you. And it's not your by your design that we're sick and ill and things that we're having to deal with, Lord. But I know and I trust that when we come to you, but you're already working in every life that's mentioned up here. And Addie Ballman, Reverend Bill Baird, Bill Beekman, Lamar Berryman, Rod Christman, Shirley Bethel, Jenny Fountain, Carol Head, Lisa Ellerby, Chris Hines, Josh Huffman, Earl Murray, the Porter family, Richard Little, Tom and Denise Risbeck, Raven Tincher, Dave Walmsley, and the family of Sherry Ellers. Lord, you know every need that is up here. And I know that you're working and you're taking care of all those needs, Lord, through healing, through deliverance, through restoration, whatever it is, Lord, you're taking care of it. Your hand is in it. I believe that. We may not see it in these loved ones, Lord, the way we want it to be, Lord, but we have to trust in your ways. Your ways are far greater than mine. So we're going to believe that you're taking, their healing is coming, however you see fit. It's your will, Lord, to be done in every one of those lives. And we just thank you this morning. We have confidence, Lord, and hope in all these requests that we have there this morning. And Lord, I'm honored that we get an opportunity to participate in this. It's an amazing thing. And we can sow back and give into your kingdom, Lord. It all belongs to you, but you asked for 10%, Lord. So I'm thanking you for letting us participate, Lord. It's an honor and an opportunity. And Lord, I just pray that you're going to go ahead because you promised that you're going to bless and multiply this tithe, Lord. And I believe that with all my heart. I see it. I believe it. I experience it, Lord. So I'm praying for every person here that's able to give today, Lord. Just bless them, bless their hands, bless their house, Lord, their businesses, whatever it is, their jobs. Lord, bless them. Give them increase, multiply them in many, many ways, Lord. I just thank you for this. I thank you for this day, and that we just give it all to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Does he really love us, or does he even care? Is there a heaven? How do we get there from here? Where did we come from? What about freedom from sin? Who is this Jesus? Why is his kingdom within? We could go on forever, on and on down the list, but the only real answers to all of our questions is this.
Father, help us to understand the reality of what you set up for us, that it's not in our wisdom and it's not in our power or our might, but it's in your Spirit. You lead us and guide us into all truth. We discern the truth of your Scriptures only through the Holy Spirit.